Hello everyone! I hope you're doing great! And let's go today for another video. I'm going to try to keep it short for once. And I want to show you a really cool Photoshop technique. And it's really easy. Like, it's really like beginner thing if you like know just a bit of Photoshop. And it's really cool. I love the result. So one of my favorite things, something that I really love to do in my picture, is changing color of the vegetation. So as you can see in the example, I love, like, the grass is supposed to be green, but I put it in red because it gives this like surrealistic, almost futuristic, you know, look. I love it. I don't know, I imagine the story of a weird future where the vegetation is like became a bit weird because of pollution or something, you know. And it's actually a really simple effect to do. So I will show you how to do it. You can do it on many things, like you can change color of anything for sure, but I will advise you to be wise with it, because it can also get kitsch, like super quickly. You know, like this visual from like 15 years ago, and it was super cool to change the color of the eyes and everything. And yeah, sometimes, and it's also from the idea that if you don't have to Photoshop it, don't Photoshop it. So obviously changing the color of the vegetation, I can't make the wall, like the whole landscape red instead of green in real life. But if it's just like, you can tweak colors of, for example, clothes, but I find it, I can see it's Photoshop, you know, when it's not really like well done. So if you can try, like, do it, but trust your instinct. If it looks weird, be careful with it. Like, for example, I see sometimes pictures change the color of like dress, and I'm like, yeah, I can see this is photoshopped, but you could have found like a blue dress straight away, maybe, maybe not, and then you don't have a choice. I used it also a lot with clients, you know, sometimes, just yesterday actually, I did some editing for photo, like editing a photo shoot for a brand, and she, like, the model had only the test product, not the final product, and the color was slightly different on the shot, so I had to put like the proper color, even if it was not a good color in real life. So it's a super useful technique, and yeah, I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's open this picture. It's a self-portrait that I took. I had pink hair, that was super cool. And I took just like when I was back in France, and let's see what it is. So I love the light in it, and it's super soft and everything. So this is out of the camera. And so I always, whatever I'm doing, I always got the habit of making a copy of my background. I never work on my background. I don't know, some, I just do it. So I'm making a copy. I press Ctrl G and it makes a copy right away. And then I'm going to add an adjustment layer on top. And so just click here at the bottom of your layer panel. And you're going to select selective color. And selective color is just magical, because you're going to have all this color here, and you're going to be able to change, to switch every one of them individually. So for example, I want the grass to be red and the flowers to be red. So I'm going to try green. And if I'm green, and I'm just going to like switch around and see what it's doing, I can see green is not really moving. Which is interesting. Oh, like adding magenta is green. Change a bit, but not so much. And adding cyan. I think like putting the grass in kind of a blue teal would be awesome as well. But I love the red. So I'm going to go in my yellows. And oh yeah, so you can see, so from my experience, more often the grass is actually more yellow. It's in the yellow. So if I'm moving it here, and as you can see, it only changed the color yellow. So I am not affected at all by this like change. So if you do it like properly, you don't really have to like do mask or anything. Ooh, so do we add a bit more? It's a bit too pink for me, but like that's not bad, huh? In like 2 seconds, maybe if we had some black. Oh yeah, so we change the intensity, the luminosity. So I will do like something like this. So we have like a really nice color. But for me, it's a bit like too bright. But look the before and after. And it took us like just 2 seconds. And I don't even have to do a mask on myself, which I like because I don't like to cut anything around. So to do a bit more into detail, because now we have this beautiful like red grass, but it's still a bit too bright for me. So I'm going to go in hue saturation. I don't know. You will forgive my French accent. I know it. And if you don't, well, there's not much I can do about it. And so I'm going to go same. You have this hue saturation panel that's open now. And you have master, and then you have this window that opened, and you're going to go in the red because we're probably in the red. Sometimes it just doesn't work, so you just change, you know, just like with the green and everything. But oh, I think it's nice. So I'm going to go like a bit less saturation, and sometimes a bit less lightness, a bit more saturation. What do you think? Maybe something more pinkish to match the hair. It's actually not bad. What do you think? Does it look like the grass was really like this? I don't know. Not really. I'm going to do a before and after. Sometimes you just have to like realize. It helps you like understand a bit more your image to do before and afters. I think it's too happy for me. So just you understand the like the principle, or is that what you say? But you see, I'm just coming back into my selective color, going into the yellows. And maybe, maybe like this, it's a bit more red and less pinkish. And my last tip, so it doesn't look as like photoshopped, I don't know. To put like everything together, when I do some editing, any kind of editing, when I like composite something, I add some texture on the skin, like a big crack or something, something that really helps is to then to put everything together. I'm using Alien Skin. I'm going to show you. So I am merging all my layers on top of it. I did an action for it, but I think I don't remember the. It's not this one. I will find you the way to merge all the visible layer on top of the one, and I will put them in the description of the video, or I will do a note here. And so I merge all my layers and I open my exposure software. So this is, you have to pay for exposure, but it's super awesome. So I can highly recommend it to you. And then it's basically, it gives you multiple options for filters, just like Instagram, but much more fancy. And can you see that right away, the first one I'm using is like super nice. I love it. Like, I love the light. And can you see how it puts all the elements together? Instead of just like being like, oh, the grass is red and I'm still here and I Photoshop something, suddenly there is like something to make it look really finish the look. Yeah, but I think, you know what? I can change the intensity of the light, but I kind of really like it. And plus, it makes sense. Like, because my light is coming from here, you can see, I don't really mind that there is this big smoky light that's a bit intense, because it still like makes sense in the picture. What do you think? Well, I already edited this picture. I just like wanted to show you a quick way to do it. Oh. And yeah, so just selective layer. Sometimes a few tweaks in like hue saturation after. And just play around, change the color. You try, you fail, even if it looks bad, it's all right. Trust your instincts. It's all about like having fun, you know, like putting yourself in the field like with flower and not giving a shit about anything else. And it's nice. Okay, my computer is dying on me, but I want to show you the before and after. What do you think? I think this is really cool. I love the cold tone and the red, like the red flowers. And I think before the filter, there were this like piece of grass that were a bit like too green, you know. We could have go into the selective color and change them, but I think by just adding this layer, it's just like added this blue teal kind of shade that I really like, and it's really like fit the skin and everything. So I think we're good, and we have a before and after. And that took us literally 2 minutes, like 30 seconds if you're like really good with Photoshop. It took me probably 10 minutes because I talk too much, but I hope you learned something. I'm sending you so much love, just like usual. And show me your results. If you try it, send me tag me on them, send me a message. I want to do what you try with it. Sending you love. And see you tomorrow.